chart, and I saw it's like, no, this thing is not possible. You just happen to have that voice to sing. But your calling, you used to intercede, you used to pray a lot, but that has been attacked. It's like now, even when you want to go before God and pray, that thing is not there. I saw your name, I had that's where they buried. Because even if you don't understand which why every day that thing does not come back to you. And you don't feel, you only, that thing, you hear it all the time. But when they are gone, it's gone. So in that process, the devil was using those people who were surrounding you to attack the call of God upon your life. So it happened with Nahweh, but we are in the process, and it was easy for Satan to come back. When the boot gate is open, now you can't, because you used to preach also. It was easy for you. It's like when God gives you a scripture, you just talk about it, and people can repent. Because it's like, I even saw you, it's like your destiny is about you preaching and people just manifesting through the teaching of the word. But you won't approve. You're going to jump back there. That calling has been attacked. It's like your destiny has been attacked. So that must be your prayer to reverse all those things always, so that God can restore everything there to you. And this thing, when it entered through a dream, and when you saw yourself, it's like I saw you, it's like you are fighting to come out of that cage. It's like a river or water. You're fighting to come out, but in that river, you are inside that water with the cage so that you cannot come out. That's how they are pressing you down like that in your calling. So you need to pray, Lord, go back, God will restore. Your prayer life, God will restore everything that is devastating you. So the only thing God is saying, I must tell you, you must surround yourself with people that are focused to the things of God. Don't surround yourself with people that have a language that does not build you. Because I see that people who are working with a language that is not right before God. That is the one that is continuously stealing. That today, a deposit that was made, like an impartation that was made inside of you. But because you don't know, immediately when you come out or have, then those people, they come, they just cause you to speak things. But even if you don't respond, that thing is taken away. So that's why every time you're mad, I would say, but he's a little bit of a little bit of a little bit. All these things, even the man is not going to fix all these things, but he, these things, you need to pray against them.
What kind of dreams, ma'am?
The one of the water, I've had a couple of them. And I had many dreams. And
things that you were telling me about washing dirty.
Or dirty things, usually. Like all the time I was washing dirty underwears, someone's dirty underwears, or I'm carrying dirty mops. Or you know, there's toilets for kids, I'm busy playing with it.
Yeah, your life is in the water. You are caged there. The water spirit. And there was a Wednesday where I was teaching about water spirits who were there. Some of you were here. Those are the most dangerous spirits that can destroy the calling or destroy anything in your life. So if they are saying you must now surround yourself with focused people, it's not a joke. If you really want God to build you up, to become that vessel that He has released before you were born, you must surround yourself with people that are focused in the things of God. You know, it's very easy to say, God is watching you as you live your life. Are you committed to Him? you trust him. If you say today you trust God, and the woman again you just and you go. No, he'll just look at you. Until that day when he's supposed to take you away. Then you go, you have to account. Why did you not do what he has said you ought to do? So water spirit is a very dangerous spirit. If you don't focus on God, it will destroy every little thing in your life. Because you will have a life there and not have a life in the physical. You will have children there and not have children in the physical. You will drive a nice car there and walk here on earth. You understand what I'm saying? So you need to pray prayers that liberate you and deliver you out of that cage. Out of that cage. And when you come here, when we pray for you, it's good. I see that you're opening up yourself. Do it more. So that whatever attachment you have to the underworld, when I say underworld, don't misinterpret me. I'm not saying you're a satanist. I'm not saying to the water, you know. Because you find that you have a man there, you are married there, but in the physical it becomes a problem. You see, because that one will fight the one that is in the physical, not to appear. You know? So I think it's a lesson to everyone. It's not only for her. Don't look at her and say, today they told her, it's also for you. Some of you have this kind of dreams. Is that you won't say it. You see yourself swimming. That is not a nice dream. In the water. So I believe that you've heard what the Spirit of God has revealed to you, and it goes for everybody. The last one.
And because it's like I see you standing on them. It's like on top of a mountain. When you're on top, you are feeling like a vibe. That's your destiny. It's like you are a great woman of God.
Amen.
But the devil has attacked that.
So see. It's just a way for you to go there. It's not even necessarily that. Understand this. Oh, yeah, okay. Do you know the prophetess, Miss Macarena? Yeah. Before she became a prophetess, she started by singing. You see here, she's worshiping. Don't you wish things happen there? She started there, but now she's a prophetess. On Friday, God was releasing more anointing on her. She was all over the floor. And we were there watching. Even the son, you know, from Apostle Margaret, I want the whole family to, they are going to be prophets, all of them. Even his son was prophesying on Friday. So I'm just saying to you, God can use foolish things to get you to where, like the song I was singing, that my shoes, my feet are dusty. They even destroy the shoes. But when Jesus comes, he will take my feet and put them on a place of victory. That's what God wants you to do. To take you out of that cage. Yeah. So stay close to God.
Yes.
I want you to pray for a cut.